Ladies and gentlemen, Spade in America with David Spade.
All right. Good crowd. Thanks for staying up. Okay, well, I got a fan letter here from Indiana, and I'd like to read it to you. It says, "Dear David, why are you such an idiot? Every time I see you on TV, I want to punch you in the face. Sincerely, Danny Minton. P.S. Why don't you ever do Hollywood Minute anymore?" Well, Danny, such a sweet kid, I get a lot of letters like this. I tell you what, for you, since you sound so cool, we will do one. So here we go. Hollywood Minute, 1995, year in review. Tony Danza's back with his new hit series, Hudson Street. If you look at a map, Hudson Street is located near the corner of Lame and Contrived. Right near where they meet. Casino. Casino. Already. But I liked it better the first time I saw it, when it was called Goodfellas. Actress Heather Harlan married Tony Randall in a private ceremony in New York, though friends say they don't expect the marriage to last long because she's only 25 and he's gay. Hi there. I've been in 4 movies this year. I'll give you $1,000 if you can name one of them. One of them. Maybe I shouldn't leave the Royal Jewels unattended. But what could happen? I'm only in New York. Durr! In one of Princess Di's love letters to her boyfriend James Hewitt, she wrote, "I need your kisses. I need your body. I need your loving." Sure, it's embarrassing, but it did get her a job writing songs for Journey. Joey Buttafuoco, Tanya Harding, John Wayne Bobbitt, all these people had 15 minutes of fame, and for Christmas, I'm donating an extra 12 seconds. Happy holidays, gang! Heather Locklear will star in an NBC TV movie about a woman with 20 personalities, which are linked by one common trait. They all can't act. Look, children, it's a falling star. Make a wish. Yeah, yes, that's right. You make a Hollywood Minute omelet, you break some eggs. Don't write the letters. You can't take the job. Well, the movie Powder came out this fall, and not many know that this was not the original title. The movie's about a bald, pale, feminine, sickly-looking guy with that people worship. The first title, Stipe! Houston, we have a problem. Before he collapsed on stage, Michael Jackson sold some of his publishing rights for $100 million. Do you have any idea how much $100 million can buy these days? 5 free molestings. That's right. It's a deal. Anna Nicole Smith was hospitalized twice this year. Her people said it was for exhaustion. For once, I believe them. If I had to lug these two giant sandbags around all day, I'd be exhausted, too. I heard she had a second spine put in. There's a new morning show, George and Lana. This is for the 8 viewers who can't keep up with the fast pace of Mike and Maddie. The woman who shot Selena was the president of her fan club. This kind of thing makes you stop and think. Why can't Michael Bolton's fan club show some initiative? So good looking, his face hurts. At night, he's like, "Oh, my head." All right, they're not all winners. Next one. They're there for pace. A vicious firebombing of a New York City subway clerk was similar to the firebombing in the movie Money Train. When learning of this terrible tragedy, a spokesperson for Columbia Pictures said, "Go see Money Train!" And finally, Andrew McCarthy and Ally Sheedy are still vacationing off the face of the earth. And that's the Hollywood Minute. We will see you next week. Get well, dude.